Hey, it's Tamara here. In this video, I will tell you my story of becoming an indie game developer. I will show you the sketches, my notes, tell you about my failed attempts and what they have taught me. So basically, it's going to be a one big devlog about all the games I've ever made. And let's not make this video too long and get right to it. You probably know that I'm in the process of developing my dream game, Lost in Athilidus. The truth is, I have developed a few more games before starting this one. Some of them were even released on itch and you can play them. But I warn you, these are my early games, so they have some bugs and might be unstable. What I'm really proud of is how much I've grown over time. The truth is, I was a little bit afraid to show you these games because they are far from perfect. But you can't get feedback unless you show your work. And this feedback is crucial for your improvement. I want to encourage you to publish your early project even if you feel like they're not good enough. Let people play them for free and share their thoughts on the game. This video is a chance for you to get to know me better. There are a lot of new people subscribing to this channel. I want to do something special when we get to 1000 subscribers. I was thinking about a Q&A video, but the only way to do it is if you ask me some questions. So leave me a comment about what you want to know about me, and when I get enough questions, I will make the video. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel, go hit that red button to get more game dev content like tutorials, tips and devlogs. My first game was written in a text engine Twine. My mom bought me a webinar about how to start making games, and it said that the easiest way to do it is to start with a text-based one. So I decided to go for it. I think I've always wanted to make games, just didn't realize how much I'd like it if I tried. The point of this game is to escape the house where you're trapped. In order to do this, you have to solve a puzzle. You have to collect 3 rune stones and put them into their places. Then solve a puzzle and find a way out. The name of the game comes from the fact that the puzzle is based on a physics equation. I was studying physics at the time, so I thought it was a nice way to combine it with entertainment. Learning the engine was a bit confusing, because I have never done programming. It has taught me the basics about game structure, if-else statements and some storytelling. To make the game look somewhat interesting, I made a few sprites, the stones with the formula. Playing the game now gave me a nostalgic feeling. It actually inspired me to work on my current game Lia more in terms of storytelling. When I was making this game, I took notes in the school notebook that I bought somewhere. I drew the rooms that were present in the house, or castle, I don't really remember what I called it. I drew my first algorithms here to show which way leads where, and also designed the puzzle for the game. After making this first game, I realized that to make the games I wanted to, I needed a more powerful tool. I don't remember why I chose Unity, probably because it is free and quite popular, which gave me the opportunity to learn the engine by myself. I followed a few tutorials from Unity Learn, but it was going hard. The learning wasn't structured well. What I needed was the basics of programming, like syntax, classes, functions, operators, etc. But instead, I jumped right into the projects. Anyway, after that I started my university studies and forgot about game development for almost half a year. After I returned to my Unity learning, I started using other tutorials from creators on YouTube. It went better than the previous time because I actually learned how to code at the university. I started making my second game called Show. I was trying to start it earlier, but the process was going too slow. As soon as I had more free time, I jumped into the development. The main character is a fluffy dandelion who runs through an endless field. He can collect the power-ups to increase his speed, which he can later exchange and get some game currency called energy. You see, I went with the physics names again. He has to avoid the bugs and also butterflies, otherwise he will fall. This game actually has a really interesting story behind it. This character comes from my mother's fairy tale that she used to read me as a bedtime story. She actually wrote this tale for me because I had been asking over and over again to read me another story, but not an ordinary one. I really like this game's concept and I want to remake it in the future, but I need your help here. You can support me on Patreon and get some extra content from me, like source files, full written tutorials and even demo versions of my games. Link is in the description. This will greatly contribute to the quality of my videos and also help me make more time for game development. This game taught me about all the components that a finished game has to have, like art, sound effects, menus, settings and other stuff. I learned about how the UI functions, how to make frame-by-frame animations, the basics of movement, collisions and rigid bodies. Another thing that I did for the first time is sharing the game with my friends, so they could play it and give me feedback. I was a little bit nervous before it, but when the game was actually out, everyone was patting me on the back and saying that I did a good job with this game. I doubt that somebody actually plays the game now because it lacks the gameplay mechanics. What this game needs is a broader storyline, side characters, adventures, and of course some polish in terms of programming. Inspired after the launch of this game, I started thinking about two new games, Formula Dash and Leah, but due to the lack of skills, the projects didn't go any further. So, how did I learn to code after all? Well, the answer for this is simple. I approached a challenging project, the one that kept me up at night, that made me push to my limits. I think it was the point when I moved from a beginner to a somewhat experienced developer. I'm still learning a lot, by the way. And the name of this project is Carcassonne. This is a board game that I've tried to implement multiple times, but never succeeded. Originally, it was an additional assignment from one of the professors at my university. Long story short, the rules of this game are mostly based on enclosing the territory. Like if you have a city area, it has to have walls from all sides. The main challenge with this is to detect when the area is finished. I tried a bunch of pathfinding algorithms, but they never really done the job, because an area can have many ends. It is not a simple line from point A to point B. I have a lot of notes on this game because I have worked on it for a long time and very hard, sometimes even too hard. The development got too intense to the point when I couldn't sleep well at night because I was constantly worried about it. In my notes you can find a lot of drawings and algorithm descriptions which I have done to detect the closed area. I've even written whole functions right on the paper. Nothing was working. Eventually, I gave up trying. I decided that it was way too hard to implement for me and I have to focus on some other things too. So I took a long break from this game. During this time, I worked on other projects that I will talk about later in the video. I just want to say that I've completed a few courses on my game development in Unity. I'm not going to disclose the platform which I used because this video is not sponsored by anybody. Anyway, I returned to this game after that, tried using a more advanced approach. If you're really curious about it, I was trying a data structure called Graph. It turns out it could have been the solution to my problems with this project, but things still didn't work the way they were supposed to work, so I decided to drop it for sure this time. And now, I just have a huge pile of notes as memories from that time. During the time I was taking a break from the previous project, I tried cooperating with another game developer. The idea was his, so I'm not sure if I can tell you about it, because maybe he's still going to develop it. But I want to talk about my key takeaways from this experience. I spent too much time planning the game to the tiny detail instead of actually developing it. I did the planning on paper, found some references, but I didn't test anything in the game. That's why with my game Leah I didn't plan the whole game ahead, but just jumped right into the development and making devlogs. This cooperation has ended because I got a full-time job and decided to focus on it. This job wasn't a great experience, but I don't want to talk about it in this video. So moving on to the next thing, my first attempt at a game jam. I came across this small 72-hour game jam about sweets and decided to participate, since I've heard it is a great way to challenge yourself to make a game in a limited period of time and with a twist. I wanted to write this game with a clean code to showcase what I've learned from the courses. I even uploaded the source code publicly. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to finish the game on time, but I still had the goal to publish it, so I worked on it later. After this game, I took another long break from game development. Managing the university studies and a full-time job became tough. I was lucky because we were on distant learning, however, I realized that I started burning out. I think at this point I have to tell you a little bit about that job. It wasn't in any way connected to the thing I like doing, making games. It was a boring office job with papers and Excel sheets. So I quit the job, and it has been one of the best decisions of my life. Well, back to the games. After getting recharged from that exhausting experience, I got back to game development. And I started with another game that is currently sitting on my computer, nearly finished but yet not published. It's called Forces. The original name was Formula Dash. I mentioned that I tried to start it earlier. The gameplay is simple. You own a candy shop, customers come to you to buy different packs of sweets, and you complete their orders. You have a few different candy combinations, which you can find in the book of recipes. I firstly made the prototype for this game. Everything worked, but at some point I lost all my motivation to continue, until I added the graphics and sounds to the game. The graphics are done by young artists who I happen to know. I want to mention a key takeaway from this game. Start adding the visual elements right at the beginning of the development. For a simple prototype, you can of course use squares and placeholders, but when you start your real project, it's better to add the art. The thing is, when you're making a game and it looks ugly, you're going to get discouraged yourself. The graphics can even help you think of something new to do in the game, perhaps inspire you to add something or improve. I'm still thinking of developing this game further, so don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn the notifications on. By the way, I want to create another social media where I can connect with you more, keep you posted, and maybe show you some behind the scenes of my work. The platforms I have in mind are Instagram, Twitter, and Discord. And also, I can set up a mailing list to share my knowledge in form of articles. Let me know in the comments which one seems more convenient to you and what would you like to see there. I want to briefly mention another attempt to participate in a game jam, where I actually submitted the game. In fact, I wasn't doing it alone. I teamed up with another developer to make a simple linear game for the narrative-driven jam. In this game, I was responsible for all the coding, and my partner did all the visuals, sounds, and dialogues. Although this game is quite simple, we had a lot more in mind compared to what we actually did, I'm still very glad that I had this experience. It was nice working with another game dev. And the last game for today, but definitely not the least, is Lost in Athilidus, my dream game. I don't see the point of telling you the story of this game over and over again, so just go watch my devlog series here. I recently started the second season of it, which is going to be dedicated completely to the activities in the game. Also, if you want to check out the latest version of the game, it is already available exclusively for my Patreon supporters. I want to thank everyone who's currently supporting me on Patreon, especially Julian Van Herve, who chose the mentioned tire. And this is it for this video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to ask me a question in the comments so I can do a Q&A in the future. Like this video and subscribe to my channel to see more game dev content from me. Bye!